Here is the next free video in the Active Directory free training course. This video looks at sites and subnets. In order for Active Directory to efficiently transfer data between different locations, you need a system that can be modeled according to your physical network. The sites feature in Active Directory allows you to divide up your network based on your network topology. Using sites, you can automatically direct your users to local resources rather than having them access the same resources over a wide area network. Sites also allow you to configure replication to best use the physical layout of your network. Consider this. If you had an office in New York and another office in London networked together, it would make sense for them to replicate off each other. If you had another office in Washington connected to the New York office, it would make sense for the Washington office to replicate changes from New York. It would not make sense for Washington to replicate changes from London. Any changes from London would be replicated to New York and then passed on from New York to Washington. Using sites in Active Directory, you can achieve this kind of result quite easily. So, what exactly is a site? According to Microsoft, a site is a group of well-connected networks. In other words, networks that are connected together via high-speed networking devices. This means a site can be more than one subnet combined together. Just like a subnet defines part of your network, a site defines part of your network. Given this example, let's say you had the network 192.168.2.0, which was located in New York. The network is the commercial network for the New York office. Due to the business suddenly growing, the business needed more space, so they rented another floor in the building. Since this was never planned for, it was given the network IP address of 192.168.20.0. Both networks are directly connected by a high-speed router. The second floor only contains a few employees, which could not fit on the original floor. In this case, it would not make sense to have the two subnets split into two sites. Using sites, you can combine both subnets together. Given this scenario, both networks would share resources with each other. Active Directory treats these two subnets as the one network location, or site. Normally, sites are connected together via a wide area network, but due to the design of your network, this may not always be the case. For example, let's say that the Washington office had a secure network separated by a firewall to the main network to ensure that the company's secrets stay in the secure network. In this case, even though the networks are well connected, you would create a site for the secure network. In most cases, the choice of sites will come down to different physical locations separated by a wide area network. In other cases, the choice of sites comes down to firewalls separating networks, and limited traffic can travel between the networks. Other times you may decide to create a site for networks where the speed between the networks is not that great or already highly utilized. For example, if you had two buildings close to each other that were separated by a wireless network that is heavily used, separating the networks into two different sites will reduce the amount of traffic traveling over that wireless network. The point to remember is that sites allow you to model Active Directory around your physical network. I will now change to my domain controller and create sites for New York, Washington, and London. To start creating some sites for my Active Directory infrastructure, I will first open Active Directory Sites and Services from Administrative Tools under the Start menu. From here, I will go down to Default First Site Name and expand it. When you first install Active Directory, this site is created, so there is somewhere to store site-related items. In it, you will see the six domain controllers that I have already installed, two each in New York, Washington, and London. You are free to create your own sites and leave the default site as is. However, most administrators will rename the default site like this. In this case, I will change the default site to New York. The next step is to create a new site for Washington and London. To do this, I will right-click Sites and select New Site. I will enter the site name in this case Washington, and below it I will select a site link. In the next video I will cover site links, so in this video I will select the default site link. Like the default site, a default site link is created when Active Directory is first installed. Once the site has been created, Windows will give you an information dialog reminding you that further configuration is required, like assigning a subnet to the site. Once I press OK, I will then follow the same procedure to create a new site for London. Once the London site has been created, I need to create a subnet for these sites. To do this, I will right-click Subnets and select New Subnet. From this dialog, I need to enter in the network address / number of bits in the subnet mask. In this case, the New York office is using 192.168.2.0 with a 24-bit subnet mask. Once I have entered in this information, I can select the site which this subnet will be associated with. Once I press OK, the subnet will be created. I then need to follow the same process for the Washington and London sites. I will enter the network address and number of bits and select to which site that subnet belongs. So far, I've only created the IP version 4 sites. If you are using IP version 6 for your network, you can create the subnets for IP version 6 following the same process. In the case of New York, I will enter in the network address followed by the number of bits, just like IP version 4, and once again select the site New York for the new subnet. Once the New York subnet is created, I will once again follow the same procedure for the Washington and London subnets. Once you have created the subnets, you will not be able to change them. However, you can always delete a subnet and create a new one if it is not correct. You can also add or remove subnets from a site at any time if required. If I go back to New York and look at the servers container, notice that all my domain controllers are under here even though they are not located in that site. To fix this, it is a simple matter to drag and drop each domain controller into the correct site. When I move the first server, I will get a dialog reminding me that moving the domain controller from site to site like this may change the settings that are applied to that server in group policy. I will cover group policy later in the course, so for the present, I will ignore this message. If these domain controllers were promoted after the sites were created, DC Promo would detect the site and the IP address of the domain controller and place the domain controller in the correct site. For this reason, you would normally not need to move a domain controller like this unless you decided to physically move the domain controller from one site to another after it had been promoted. You may notice when creating sites and subnets that the process is quite repetitive and slow. Once done, you are unlikely to make changes, or at least make changes very often. If you worked in an IT help desk, you may have come across an end user in a panic because all their important files have been deleted. On closer inspection, it is shown that the files have been accidentally moved to another location because of a misclick. To protect your sites and subnet from misclicks, you can open the properties for any of the objects, select the Object tab, and tick the box Protect Object from Accidental Deletion. Once this option is ticked, if an attempt is made to move or delete the object, a message will appear saying access is denied. In order to move or delete the object, this tick box must be cleared. Considering how long it takes to set up the sites and subnets, and how rare it is for changes to occur, it is worth taking the time to tick this box. That's it for creating sites and subnets in Active Directory. In the next video, I will look at how replication and site links work in Active Directory. Site links form the backbone for replication in Active Directory to match the design and current state of your network. Thanks for watching another free video from IT Free Training. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest free videos.